What is going on, world? It's your boy Steve Dab 317, and by popular demand, I actually took the Trackhawk out to the track. Oddly enough, my very first run, and that's what you're looking at right now. There was another Trackhawk in line. He kind of waved me ahead, so I'm like, yo, that'd be dope. He said he was stock. I was running stock. But here's the crazy part, as you kind of know from the video thumbnail, like, dude driving this other Trackhawk, man, it was a young cat, man. He was like 17, 18 years old. And funny thing is, like, as we were going up to the line, or as I was getting out to set up my GoPro, you know, I had it facing backwards a little bit for, you know, when I'm out there gapping people or whatever. He was like, hey, and you know, we were just out there just kind of laughing and joking, but he's like, you may want to go ahead and face that GoPro facing forward a little bit, you know. But anyways, we get up here to the line, man. He pre-staged and staged. So this is my first run. I was already nervous, not making excuses or anything like that. But I got up there. I tried activating the launch control. And, man, long story short, I slept like something horrible. And you can see basically what I was running, the exact same vehicle near the exact same setup. Wasn't much I can do with him by the time he got to that point. So I absolutely got destroyed. And I will say, and again, I'm going to say all this. This isn't to make an excuse or anything like that. But in terms of how much I slept the light on that very first run, off the light, I was a 0.774. He ran a 0.220, so obviously reaction time much better than mine. Now, in terms of the ET, he ran a 11.935. I ran 11.90 flat. So, our settings were a little bit different. We kind of talked about that before the fact. So, I ran quicker than he did, but long story short, he was just a better driver. Like, there's no other way of putting it. You know, I debated on posting this video. I'm like, yo, should I even put this on my channel, man? I didn't just got destroyed by who I would call a youngster, you know. But at the same time, I'm like, you know what? I gotta respect his grind. I gotta respect his shine. I mean, heck, at 17, I was driving like an 86 Ford Thunderbird, and you know what I'm saying? I may have been lucky if I had 200 horsepower. I had the V6. It wasn't even turbocharged. And, you know, here he is in high school pushing a 707 horsepower Trackhawk, you know. So that's actually kind of dope, man. But what I will say is after the run, I went down. I was kind of speaking with him and some other people down there. And, you know, I got a lot of great feedback. And that's probably the part that I really admired most about being out there at the track, was just kind of, you know, I was out there, I asked some questions, had some good laughs, you know, people gave me some advice and tips and things like that. But I will say, and something that I'm proud of, every subsequent run, my timing at the tree was a lot different. I actually called my Uncle Eric, and I was talking to him about how, like, from the outside looking in or from the stands looking, I've been to the track multiple times, but, like, it never seemed like, it didn't seem like it was that difficult to run. It's like, you know what I'm saying, you get set, you watch the tree, you time the tree the best you can, boom, you take off, keep the wheel straight, not a problem. And granted, I'm pushing an automatic transmission. I know with manual there's a lot more than that, but like, and like I told him, once I got out there, between, you know, I look over, I seen that the guy on the other side, he had pre-staged and then staged. I'm like, dang, I've got to hurry up. Apparently you get like 8 to 10 seconds or something like that, but in my mind, like, this was like the final countdown. I had to hurry up and get up there. I hurry up and got up there. Then I wanted to use launch control. And for those of you who are familiar with the launch control in a Trackhawk, you've got to make sure your steering wheel is absolutely perfectly straight or pretty close to it. You've got to, then you got to go through your little sequence. And, you know, I was dialed in to what RPM I wanted to launch at and trying to gauge how much brake pressure. Like, it was really crazy because it seemed like there was so much I was trying to remember and so much I was trying to do in a short period of time. And like I said, it kind of bit me in the butt a little bit, but I was glad that I got to make it down in time for Uncle Leo. If you kind of take a glance, you can kind of see Uncle Leo taking off, running a blazing, I want to say, oh, this was his first run. Man, Danny slept at, like, I slept like bad. I ain't go cat, but like Danny, like, I think they may have had to go down and knock on that man window to let him know that the light had changed colors. I was making fun of him, told him it looked like he went on a second green. But so anyways, you know, it was overall an absolute great experience. I think right here on the side, I mean, this is actually Guy Rand. I think this is his dad right here talking to me, and I think this is when he was just kind of telling me some, just little small tips and things like that. But I will say, I got better at cutting the light. I think I did 4 runs. I'll probably upload those also. But with each of those runs, you know, I got better at cutting the light, and I learned a lot about the Jeep. One of the things I did, and I think you can see it in this video, I pulled back around and I cut the Jeep off and I opened the hood. Not because I knew what I was doing or anything, but I noticed the other people at the track doing that. So I was like, hey, it must be a reason. You know what I mean? So I just kind of followed suit. You know, as you can kind of see the other vehicles there. And I think I ran this Mustang that's kind of sitting right here. Matter of fact, I did run this Mustang. I ran this Mustang next. I'm actually not going to talk a lot about it right now, but in the next video, I will. And I think I actually stopped to ask him questions or something. But yeah, man, it's one of those things, man. I was, all things considered, you know, I was happy with the performance of the Jeep, happy with the performance of myself. I learned a lot. It was good to kind of get those early on nervous jitters out the way. If you can remember your very first time running at the track, and, you know, I don't know, maybe if you had the jitters, if you used that little porta potty thing right there. I went in there, I didn't even really have to pee, apparently, but in my mind, I felt like I did, you know, so got that out the way. Once I got to going down the track, it was pretty cool. You know, it's a lot different, like doing that speeds, like the track was like, it was like butter. It was so smooth, it was almost weird a little bit. But I mean, no dips, no divots, no, I mean, it was just a very smooth, straight shot, you know. And so yeah, I mean, it was a great learning, actually, right there. That's the guy who I raced. So like I said, even afterwards, you know, we kind of talked and stuff and laughed. You know, I told him, I was like, I think I probably should have took your advice and went ahead and angled that camera forward, you know. But like I said, it was all fun and games. I'm definitely appreciative of the experience. I'm glad I got to run another Trackhawk. That was pretty cool. You know, I also got to kind of look at his times, look at my time, and I learned a lot from that in terms of what the Jeep was capable of. But yo, again, kudos to him, man. Shout outs to him. He was the better man. He was a better driver, you know. I'm gonna guess that wasn't his very first rodeo, but dude, he dogged me out the, you know, off the tree. You know, ain't nothing I can do about that but learn and get better. So hey, I appreciate you watching my very first run. I'm glad you can be a part of it. I'm gonna go ahead and sign off for the moment, but hey, appreciate you all, appreciate you being here, appreciate you watching. I appreciate every single like and subscribe. If you look in the front of the camera, if you rotate it around, you will see Uncle Leo coming back around the corner. Yeah, so check him out on Instagram also. But hey, stay tuned, I've got more videos coming your way. Steve Dab 317, and I am signing out.